how some companies will use AI to obliterate yours. When the internet became big and viable for businesses, both Macy's and Amazon used it, just in different ways. Macy's created a portal for people to shop at their store. Amazon created a completely new business model of shopping. While Macy's had retail stores with employees to pay, rents to pay, and lights to keep on, Amazon had none of this to worry about. They could save money and offer a broad range of products. The difference is that Macy's integrated the internet, while Amazon used it as a foundation for their business model. So some of you are asking, what's the big difference? Well, think of it this way. What happens if you pull out the internet? Make it disappear. Amazon will cease to exist, but Macy's will still. Because the difference is that Amazon uses the internet as its foundation. Companies are wrestling with the same problem now, just with a different technology, artificial intelligence. So let's think about Macy's and Amazon's in this new world. Here's how a company works. It makes products or designs services, which is the operational part of the business. Then it offers these products and services to their customers who pay for it. The company also gathers data about a bunch of other things, like products, customers, operations, metrics, and pretty much anything else that they plan to use or use. The company could insert AI on the customer side to offer things like chatbots, use it in their business processes for improvement, or use it in their data to make predictions. If Macy's were to use AI, that's how they would probably do it. On the other hand, think of a new Amazon being created, but it's going to use AI at its foundation. So what are some possibilities here? First, let's see what AI can do today. It can recognize objects and images, can model complex rules with data sets, and can process large amounts of data to find underlying patterns, among other things. The new Amazon could use AI for these tasks. In some cases, AI will replace people, and in others, AI will simplify processes. Here's a tangible example. We all buy insurance. The premium we pay for the car is proportional to the risk. If we live in a bad neighborhood, we pay more. One company could specialize in risk by gathering data from multiple sources, such as credit agencies, crime reporting agencies, weather companies, people data, and others, to compute a risk score on you and the car. Internally, they use AI to digest all this data and create models. Just like how companies can check the credit history of a person, these companies can offer risk scores to other companies. Now, risk is only one part of insurance. What about quoting, billing, payments, and claims? Now, imagine that multiple companies sprout up and each one specializes in one part of this whole process. This is a completely new business model for insurance, and each company has a specific role to play in this big ecosystem. Maybe another AI company will simply orchestrate the connections among the new ones to provide an end-to-end experience for the customer who doesn't need to know what's behind the scene and that a bunch of companies are working together. So this is serious competition. If your company's business model is outdated, it can't compete. Like Macy's, that's having a tough time against Amazon. It's not the problem with the people at Amazon being too smart or working harder. It's the business model that makes this huge difference. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and consider subscribing.